Hello viewer, welcome to my YouTube channel Software Testing. Today I'll show you how you can download and install PyCharm on your system. As you know, for Python programming, PyCharm is one of the most popular and famous editor. So let's go to the computer screen. I'll show you step by step process how to download and install PyCharm and create a new project for Python. Now I am at computer screen. And as per discussion, today's topic is the way. So PyCharm download and install. So first we will open any browser and navigate to jetbrains.com/PyCharm. And also we'll download community edition, because pro edition you need to pay, will not go there. So then install PyCharm. After installing, we'll open PyCharm, then create a Python sample project and we'll run Python code. That's all for today's tutorial. So in order to do that, first we need to open any browser. So you can navigate the for PyCharm download either way. First go to google.com. Both way I am showing. Just type over here PyCharm download. And then go to first JetBrains. This is the first website. Click over here. Once you click over here, PyCharm has the two different edition, PyCharm Professional and PyCharm Community Edition. We will go for PyCharm Community Edition. I'll show you other way. So go to jetbrains.com/PyCharm. Here you need to come up over here, download button. Once you click download, you will get both version over here, Pro version and Community Edition. So here is the Pro version, Professional. So we'll download from here. Now it is in the same page as like previous one. So click download over here. Once you click download, it will start downloading. You see download in progress. If your download doesn't in progress, then you need to click over here, download and verify the file from here too, or direct link to. So either way it will work, but depend on your internet speed. It will take little time, not that much. It is almost completed download. Okay, it is completed. It will give you the message that PyCharm download completed. You see the message over here. You can directly click over here for Python install, or you can go to the folder option too, show in folder. So once you are in show in folder, this is the PyCharm exe file. So let me minimize the browser. So double click on the PyCharm exe file, whatever downloaded, then PyCharm install will be start. So double click over here. Let me minimize this window too. You see it is initializing. Then first you need to click yes in this window. That means this app will make changes to your device that pop up. Click yes. Once you click yes, the installation window comes up this way. So then click next. Here is the location where you want to install your software. I'm going to the default. If you don't want to install in default location, then you can click browse, then you can provide your location, then click next. So it is asking couple of things. PyCharm Community Edition. I need a desktop icon, so I am clicking over here. Also, I need to path variable to be added over here. So later, another two things. I don't need that. Then click next. So thereafter, you need to click install. Once you click install, it will start installing, and it will take some time. So that's why I'm pausing my video over here. You see installing is almost done. So most of the time depends on the software, installing takes some time, similar way PyCharm too. So as we are installing PyCharm, definitely in order to write the Python code, you need to install Python on your system too. Those who are new in PyCharm and Python, you can watch my previous video how to install Python on your system. It is done. So now it is asking reboot now. I want to manually reboot later. So for the installing purpose and video purpose, I'm not doing reboot right now. Click finish. Once you click finish, let me show my desktop, showing desktop. After install, as we selected create desktop icon for PyCharm, it is that icon. So double click on there, it will open PyCharm. You see JetBrains IDE PyCharm. So now it is asking creating a project, new project, open project, or get from VCS, version control, like GitHub, SVN, or somewhere else. So if you have project already, you can open from here. Also, you can take your project from the version control, as we will not do anything next to, we'll create a new project. Click new project. Once you create new project, it is where you want to create a new project. I'll create a project in desktop as a Python project and custom environment. You see, select existing or generate environment. We want to generate new environment over here. This is the Python interpreter, your Python exe file over here. So then once everything is selected, then click create. Once you will click create, it will create a project for you. It takes little time, first time creating your project, because it will create your virtual environment, then it will create your project within that. Okay, project is created. Maximize the window. You see, here is the script. If you expand the script, all the Python file, exe file, everything is over here. So once you are in this place, you see Python project is selected. Right click on Python project, new, here is the Python file. Click Python file, here it is asking. You can name your file anything. I am naming Hello Python. Then hit enter from keyboard. You see Hello Python file is created, our project created, Python file created. Here is the window, you can write your code over here. So let me write the print command. Hello Python. So then you can right click and run Hello Python test, or you can run from here from the run button. So either way it will work. Run. You see Hello Python is printed. That means Python download and install successful, and also Python project created as expected. So that's all for today's tutorial. Those who are new in Python programming and also PyCharm download and installation, this video will be very helpful for themselves. If you think this is helpful, please like my video, subscribe my channel, and share it to others. Also, if you have any question, please make a comment. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you for watching this video.